It's a still life watercolor of an now late afternoon. As the sun shines through the curtain lace and shadows wash the room, and we sit and drink our coffee. Like shells upon the shore, you can hear the ocean roar in the dangling conversation and the superficial sighs, the borders of our lives. And you read your Emily.
Hey. How often do you get your hair cut?
When I already decide it's time for a change.
I get mine cut every fourth Thursday. By the same barber. I think I've gone to this guy my whole life, and I haven't even talked to him.
You've really been going there for 20 years, and you've never talked to him?
Well, it couldn't have been my whole life. We moved here when I was little, so probably then.
And you've never talked with him? Not hello? Goodbye?
Well, we always sort of just nodded to each other. And, I mean, I've always had something to read, so there was never any need to.
What about to tell him how much to cut off, or what to do differently? You've never had a different haircut, have you?
No. No, I haven't.
It's kind of weird, John.
Yeah, well, I think next time I'm going to talk to him. I don't even think I know his name.
Call your mom.
Nah, I'll just talk to him.
Maybe you can get a new haircut also.
Afternoon. They said it was gonna show signs of rain today, but it hasn't yet. Is that your wife?
Nope.
Thank you.
That's a lot to expect. My, my, oh my. My, my, oh my. My, oh my, oh my.
We're home.
Hey guys, how was playgroup?
Pretty good. Made some new friends.
It is such a lovely day out. I think I'm going to take Amanda for a walk.
Really?
Do you know where the stroller is?
Stroller? Do you need it? I mean, she doesn't really fit. I don't think she even likes being in the stroller that much.
Found it!
Darling, I feel like you're starting to ignore Molly.
Ignore Molly?
Yeah.
Don't be silly. I would never forget about Molly. I'll be back in about an hour. The sun's so beautiful right now.
I just feel like this is something we should talk about now.
I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
I'm fine. What were you thinking? You could have hurt my baby.
Is your kid okay?
We'll be fine as soon as you leave us alone.
Sorry.
Amanda, look! Look what I got you! Yes! Carl, could you come and have a look at this?
What is it?
I'm getting a weird signal.
What kind of frequency distribution does it have?
I don't know. I'll run an FFT and see what it says. Wow, that's weird. What do you think that is?
I've never seen a star like that. It looks man-made.
What's in its position?
I'll go check.
Right ascension, 14 hours, 24 minutes, 9 seconds. Declination, 18 degrees, 48 minutes, 12 seconds.
That's right where the new supernova was discovered.
Call Caltech and see if they can confirm this. I'm gonna go take a closer look at the scope. Come up when you're done.
Caltech said they're looking into it.
Great, I've almost got it in view. I'll do a longer time scan of the signal.
See if it drifts at all or if it stays with the supernova.
How long do you think I should capture?
3 minutes should do it.
So, do you think this might be, you know, something important?
I doubt it. Do you?
I don't know. I hope it is. I mean, this is honestly what got me interested in astronomy in the first place.
You mean extraterrestrial intelligence?
Yeah, the idea that we're not alone. It would mean that there's something out there that it was alive and that we could talk to and share the universe with. Right now it's kind of lonely.
So how old were you?
What?
When you first got into astronomy.
Oh, I was 12. Yeah, it was the year when Halley's Comet last came across the Earth. I thought it was, like, maybe a spaceship or something, and so I wanted to take a closer look at it. And I asked my mom for a telescope so that I could look at it, and I got it for Christmas, and it came with this great book all about the stars. And the telescope sucked, but the book really fascinated me. And I've been hooked ever since. How about you?
Oh, there was no specific time or incident or anything. It's just, as long as I can remember, I've loved watching the stars. I knew all the constellations when I was 9. I actually talked to them. Ursa Minor was my favorite. I don't know, I always felt kind of bad for him. Like he was being overshadowed by Ursa Major. I guess I figured probably he was lonely and maybe could use a friend.
Did it ever bother you that your friends never talked back?
Not really. I mean, what I love about astronomy is it's the only science where all you do is observe, and there's no interaction.
It looks like the scan's almost done.
That's probably Caltech.
Scan's done. I'll check it out and then come down.
Oh, okay, thanks. Sorry for the trouble.
What'd they say?
Apparently there's a new military satellite that was deployed to that area. It just started test broadcasting today.
Yeah, the scan showed that the signal moved away from the supernova, so it's just a coincidence. I shouldn't have got my hopes up. That was stupid.
I'm sorry. Hey, Elaine?
Yeah?
I was wondering, we're almost done here tonight. When we leave, do you want to go get a drink with me or something? Unless you don't want to.
Sure. Yeah, I like that.
Why didn't you say anything?
Fear rejection.
Well, we've no need to fear that anymore.
Hey, Susie, what's up?
I keep catching myself looking out that window for him. Can I sit here?
Yeah, of course. You got out of work. Yeah.
Thanks. Shit, I've gotta run. Jen, why do you have to leave?
'Cause he has to win the bread, make a life. If he's not doing anything productive, he begins to hate himself.
He didn't have a job for the 3 months we dated.
Yeah.
Oh.
Listen, I'm sorry. I didn't mean
don't
to...
Don't Now you're the sleeping beauty. Jen, how quick did you get over your last boyfriend? Wrong term. How long did it take you to get over your last love?
Much too long.
I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Susie, you're never gonna guess what happened today. Do you remember our TA, Michelle?
That horrible bitch.
Yeah, she was on her way to class, and there's this troop of bikes. I mean, I hate bikes too, but she refused to move out of the way, like, wouldn't budge an inch.
And she won?
No, she completely got run over. Like, these two bikes tried to swerve and just ran into her. There's, like, this huge tangle of bodies on the ground. Like, everyone was just, like, screaming. It was hilarious.
Jen, what are we doing?
No idea.
How long have you been...
Not sure. For a while now.
How much longer do you think you'll be up?
Don't much care. You?
I'll be studying all night.
Study breakdown?
No, I've got work to catch up on.
Figured it would end sooner or later.
I should do this in my room. Besides, I don't have a reason to fear windows anymore.
Awake. I just had the worst nightmare. I can't even tell you how fucking frightening it was. I think I was choking on something. Strings or something. God, that was terrible. Hey, Sarah? Is it okay if I sleep here?
Sure.
Good night.
What? That's a terrible way to die. Jesus.
You mean hilarious? Anyway, I definitely want to tie it into my thesis somehow.
You mean the thesis that everyone's gonna flip over because Victorian mourning is making such a comeback these days?
Whatever. Oh, shit. Did I show you this locket I found?
Where'd you find it?
Sarah was all freaked out by it.
What the hell is that? Whose hair is that?
That's the awesome part.
You found a locket with hair in it? Gross, man. I would not have touched that thing after I saw what was in it. That's fucking creepy.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I liked it a lot.
Well, I think Sarah had a point. Where is she, by the way?
Anyway, it fits right in with my thesis. Like Victorians actually used to keep hair in lockets for mourning loved ones.
Okay, weirdo. You seriously need to throw that thing away. You're taking your little thesis thing way too far.
Whatever, Erin. You just know I'm cooler than you are.
Yeah.
I'll never be the same since I
Neutron, proton, mass effect. Lyrical oxidation, you're irrelevant. Mass spectrograph, your electron volt. Atomic energy erupting as I get all open on betatrons, gamma rays, thermal cracking, cyclotron, any and every mic you're on. Transuranium, if y'all was uranium. Molecule spontaneous combustion. Speech is my hammer, bang the world into shape, now let it fall. Huh. My restlessness is my nemesis. It's hard to really chill and sit still. Committed to page, I write around. Sometimes won't finish for days. Scrutinize my literature from the large to the miniature. I mathematically add, minister, subtract the wax, selector, will it back. I'm feeling that. From the core to the perimeter, black. You know the motto. Stay fluid, even in staccato. Most deaf, full blooded, full throttle. Breathe deep inside the drum hollow.
Ne me quitte pas, il faut oublier tout, le soulier qui s'enfuit déjà, oublier le temps des malentendus et le temps perdu, à savoir comment oublier ces heures qui tuaient parfois, coup de pourquoi le cœur du bonheur ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas.
Yeah. distracted.